Welcome all. Today we have to continue our lecture on the topic 1.2. On to the summit, we reach the top. This is our fourth lecture on this topic. Today we have to complete this story. We have seen one of the adventurous stories here. I am Professor Tushar Chavan from Rashtriya Junior College, Chalisgaon, District Jalgaon. I have always uploaded online lectures on my YouTube channel, Learn with Tushar Chavan. You can also visit my blog juniorcollegeteacher.blogspot.in. I have also written two activity books for standard 11 and 12. You can also get various activities there. Now we have to continue our session. The last topic, last section of this adventurous story, on to the summit, we reach the top. This is the story which was told by Tenzing Norgay. He was one of the participants of this expedition, and he had reached at the topmost position of the mountain, Mount Everest. Now he was telling his journey. See the remaining part of this story. Tenzing Norgay said, when he was climbing down along with Edmund Hillary, they had to reach to the base camp, and so they were climbing down one by one. Initially, Tenzing Norgay, he was leading when they were climbing up, but now Edmund Hillary, he was the person who was leading that expedition. Now Tenzing Norgay said, I raised my arm with my thumb up, CWF, Noisy, and WG Lowe saw us and their faces flushed with joy. Now when these two persons achieved their target, they reached at the topmost position of Mount Everest, they hoisted four flags there, they took photographs of their success, and they came back. When they reached to the lower camp, two persons were present there. One is Noisy, another is Lowe. They saw Tenzing and Edmund Hillary. These two persons also saw Noisy and Lowe, their companions. They raised their thumb up. It is a sign of victory. Means Tenzing was telling that he and Edmund Hillary became successful to achieve their target. They were very happy because they became successful in their attempt. So they raised their thumb up. The faces of Noisy and Lowe also seemed to be joyful. Tenzing ज्यावेळेस खाली येतोय आपल्या या सहकाऱ्यासोबत, माउंट एव्हरेस्टचं शिखर सर करून तो खाली येतोय. खाली आल्यानंतर त्या खालच्या कॅम्पमध्ये दोन व्यक्ती, त्यांचे सहकारी उपस्थित होते. एक म्हणजे CWF नॉयसी आणि दुसरा होता WG लोवे. त्यांच्याकडे पाहून टेन्झिंगने थंब अप केला आणि त्या दोघांना कळलं की यांनी विक्ट्री मिळवलेली आहे त्यांचे चेहरे आनंदाने फुलून गेलेले होते. दे वर व्हेरी हॅपी बिकॉज देअर कंपेनियन सक्सीडेड. नाउ व्हॉट इज सी डब्ल्यू एफ विच वॉज रिटन बिफोर द नेम ऑफ नॉइसी? इट इज द शॉर्ट फॉर्म. सी द लॉन्ग फॉर्म ऑफ हिज नेम. This Noisy was an English mountaineer and author. He was a member of the 1953 British expedition that made the first ascent of Mount Everest. Now this Noisy was one of the member of this expedition on which many other persons were also working. And Tenzing and Edmund became successful in that expedition. This Noisy was one of the member, and he was staying on the lower camp, Camp 8. So his name was given as C.W.F. Noisy. Another person who was also present there, it was Lowey. His name was given as W.G. Lowey. It is also short form of his name. He was known as George Lowey. He was a New Zealand born mountaineer, explorer, film director and educator. He was also member of the expedition. Tya doghai mountaineer cha short form dilela ahe textbook madhe. Tyanche purna naav ya thikane mi dakhavlele ahe. Doghai mountaineer he या एक्सपिडिशनचे मेंबर होते, सहकारी होते आणि या टेन्झिंग आणि एडमंड हिलरीला यश मिळवून देण्यासाठी त्यांची मदत झालेली होती. या दोघांना प्रचंड आनंद झाला की ज्यावेळेस माउंट एव्हरेस्टवर चढाई करून हे दोघे जण खाली आलेले होते. इन दिस वे टेन्झिंग नोर्गे वॉज सेइंग, इन दिस वे I was able to tell them of our success. Now on the return journey, Tenzing Norgay was telling the story of his success along with Edmund Hillary. He was telling how they reached at the topmost position of Mount Everest, how they had installed four flags, how he had offered offerings to God. तर या परतीच्या प्रवासामध्ये टेन्झिंग नोर्गे त्या दोघांना यशाची स्टोरी सांगतोय. एज वी गॉट नियरर टू कॅम्प 8 लोवे केम टू मीट अस अँड केम अप अबाउट 300 फीट विथ टी अँड कॉफी. नाउ ऑन देअर जर्नी वेन दे वेर व्हेरी नियर टू कॅम्प 8 दिस लोवे ऑल्सो केम. ही केम अप अबाउट 300 feet. हा जो लोवे होता त्यांनी पाहिलं हे दोघे जण आता जवळ येत आहेत, धावत पळत तोही वरती चढतोय. 300 फूट अंतर चढून गेल्यानंतर त्यांना तो चहा आणि कॉफी ऑफर करतोय. ही वॉज व्हेरी हॅपी बिकॉज हिज टू कंपेनियन्स बिकेम सक्सेसफुल अँड ही ऑफर्ड देम टी अँड कॉफी एज अ रिफ्रेशमेंट. तर या लोवेला वाटतंय की हे दोघे जण एवढ्या उंच अंतरावरून शिखरावरून खाली येत आहेत, थकलेले असतील आणि खरोखर टेन्झिंगला तहान लागलेली होती. ही कुडंट ड्रिंक अ ड्रॉप ऑफ वॉटर बिकॉज इट वॉज फ्रोझन. या टेन्झिंगला खरोखर तहान लागलेली होती, त्याला पाणी पिता आलेलं नव्हतं. अशा या टेन्झिंग आणि एडमंडला 300 फूट वरती जाऊन चहा आणि कॉफी देण्याचं काम या लोवेने केलेलं होतं. He climbed up 300 feet with tea and coffee. त्या दोघांना शक्ती यावी, एनर्जी यावी या पद्धतीने लोवेने त्यांना चहा आणि कॉफी देऊन गेलेली होती. Another 50 feet down, we met Noisy, who brought us more tea. Now see, Noisy was also there. He also brought more tea for Tenzing and Edmund Hillary. या नोईसेलाही वाटलं आपण यांना रिफ्रेशमेंट म्हणून एनर्जी म्हणून चहा द्यावी म्हणून 250 फूट हे तिघे जण खाली आल्यानंतर चहा घेऊन हजर राहिलेला आहे. तो त्या दोघांना चहा ऑफर करतो आणि खरोखर टेन्झिंग आणि एडमंड हिलरी आता थकलेले होते, एवढ्या उंचावर जाऊन खाली आलेले होते, त्यांना रिफ्रेशमेंटसाठी या पद्धतीने चहाची गरजच होती. सो नॉईसी ऑफर्ड देम टी, मोर टी. नाउ हियर यू विल फाइंड अनदर इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग, दिस टी स्मेल्ड केरोसिन. नाउ दिस टी वॉज ब्रॉट एज refreshment for them, but it was smelling with kerosene. Apparently it had been made in a hurry and somehow some kerosene got into the welcome cup. It was clear that the person who carried it, he was in hurry, so few drops of kerosene might be held in that tea, and that is why it was smelling with kerosene. घाई घाई नाही हा चहा त्या दोघांसाठी त्यांनी बनवलेला असेल. रॉकेलच्या स्टोववर तो चहा बनवलेला असेल आणि घाई गर्दीमध्ये काही केरोसिनचे थेंब त्या चहामध्ये पडलेले होते. साहजिकच त्या चहाला रॉकेलचा वास येत होता. But it was a welcome cup, though it smelled kerosene. These two persons, Tenzing and Edmund Hillary, they accepted it as a welcome cup. But I thought, since the gentleman had taken so much trouble to bring it, I was going to enjoy it, whatever the smell. Now here, you will find the broad mind of Tenzing. He realized that it was smelling with kerosene, but he did not reject it because he knew that person had brought that tea as a refreshment for them. He had taken much effort, much trouble to bring it, and that is why he had taken it, though it was smelling. He accepted it, enjoyed it. In this way, the journey of Tenzing and Edmund Hillary was given here. They became successful. They were the first persons who reached for the first time on the topmost position of Mount Everest. They made history, and the success story was given here. Now you had enjoyed the story. In the exam, you have to write answers of various activities. Our evaluation pattern is now activity based, and that is why you need a good practice of various activities. And that is why you have to deal with a lot of activities on every passage. If you do good practice of solving or giving answers of the activities, you will definitely get good marks in the exam. Apli pariksha paddhati ata activity based ahe. Krutiyukta activity sheet tumhala dili jail. Tyamdhye answers कसे लिहायचे असतात तिथे एक प्रॅक्टिस तुम्हाला करावी लागेल. अँड दिस बुक ऍक्टिव्हिटी वर्क बुक डेफिनेटली हेल्प यू. यू हॅव टू बाय दिस बुक अँड टेक द आन्सर्स ऑफ दीज ऍक्टिव्हिटीज. नाऊ आय एम स्टॉपिंग हियर.